Hi, welcome back to my channel. I thought I would
flip
of my 5-year cousin that I've been using as a sketchbook. I have not been doodling in this thing in 2023 religiously. I did in the beginning and then I sort of fell off the wagon. 2023 drawings will be over here. 2024 will be right there. And I've been using watercolor. So whatever I draw, a description's over here. I keep track of the weather, the day, and then in 2024, I started keeping track of the humidity. And I left this one in pencil so that you could see that this is generally how I start off. That's supposed to be fruit stripe gum. Now from this point on, it will be pictures from 2023. And that has a really shimmery look. This is a bald eagle. This is Jackie from Big Bear with her 2 eggs last year. That's an octopus. That's supposed to be a clam shell digging into the sand. Mr. Toad. And this one's also shimmery. This one I think I used watercolor pencils. That's supposed to be a blue crab. It's supposed to be a hermit crab with a can, a metal can as its shell. Sleeping monkey, a fox. It's supposed to be a sleeping dog. It looks like Bruce, but that's not Bruce. And then I got onto a starfish kick. And the real pictures, the real images of this is much better than my drawing. This is supposed to be a California roll, a yellow duckling, king vulture, Egyptian vulture. This is where I was on my little bird kick. Baby birds in a nest. Owl. This is a red slider turtle. I had two. Now I just have one, Bert and Ernie. But Ernie used to sit like this. The two turtles would stack. So Bert would always be on the bottom. Ernie would be on top. And this is how she would sun. And I wanted to draw that because I just thought it was really cute. Two elephants. Here's another starfish. You can't tell, but there's a caterpillar under there. And this is how it protects itself, by stacking little pieces of wood on top of it. And they're underneath on the bottom. Bleeding heart. A flounder. This is a moonflower. I tried to grow this last year, which is why I drew the picture. And I had no luck. So I'm trying again this year. I just started some seeds a couple of days ago. And then here's a halibut. And the difference between a halibut and a flounder, this is a saltwater fish. This one's also saltwater too, but I think the halibut, yeah, it's bigger and longer. So you can see what that looks like versus a flounder. Who knew? Well, I didn't. I don't eat seafood. Red snapper. Okay, so this is where I was on a kick with bald eagles. This is a year and a half. At 2.5 years, it's starting to look like this. 3.5 years. Here we are at 4.5. This is what an eagle is supposed to look like, but obviously my drawing doesn't cut it. This year is going to be a leap year. This is what I'm drawing on February 29. This is a snake. Here's a penguin walking in South Africa. This is the blue-footed booby. Okay, on this, when I started drawing these guys, I discovered that there are more than one footed booby. I watched this bird movie with Steve Martin and I think Jack Black a number of years ago, where their quest was to try to spot a blue-footed booby. Which, hello, there it is. But then there's more. So this is the red one. This is the brown-footed booby, which is interesting because its feet are kind of yellowish. This is the mask-footed booby. This is the white-faced heron. Okay, so this is when I was on my bird kick. And again, you can see the shimmery look. King cobra. So this is where I think I started to fall off. I stayed with the weather, kept track of that, but obviously no drawings. In March, was on a Disney kick, so I decided to draw some of their marquee things at the different food booths. So this is the adorable snowman Frosted Treats in Disney California Adventure. This is the Cozy Cone. Flo's Cafe, also in DCA. Okay, then I think I went back on the bird kick. So I started looking for national birds. So this is of Mexico, Canada, China, New Zealand. I try to draw a kitten. That's what it looks like. Then I decided to try state birds. So this is Alabama, it's a northern flicker. Okay, some of these I won't be able to pronounce, but this is the one from Alaska, Arizona, Arkansas, California, Colorado, Connecticut. The state bird of Delaware is the blue hen. So I gave him some shimmery feathers. Now, Florida, I think, their state bird is similar to a bird that I previously drew, which is why I left it blank. Because I was like, okay, Florida has the same bird as one that I already drew, and I didn't want to draw it again. So I put Florida down, deciding, what am I going to put here? So, obviously, I did not decide. This is the state bird of Georgia. And you can see that it's in pencil. State bird of Hawaii. I think it's pronounced Nene. So didn't color him in. So here again, I fell off. And I don't stress out with the blank pages. This is supposed to be a fun activity for me. My goal of doing this is to try to improve my sketching, doodling abilities. Which, I can't say that it looks much better. I picked back up at the end of May. This is a whale shark. Okay, nothing there. What is this? The Hobonichi Challenge Most Loved TV Show or Movie. I picked A Christmas Story. It's my favorite Christmas movie. And then I fell off the wagon again. Again, no big deal. So this is why I've been hesitant about sharing this, because there's not a complete flip through of my 5-year. This is a picture, supposed to be a picture, of a deep sea octopus nursery that they discovered in Costa Rica. So that's what I was trying to draw. So these are supposed to be baby octopus, and then these are like the egg sacs of the octopus. So if you look this picture up, it's really pretty. This is a coconut crab. This thing is gigantic. This is from Crow. It's the Clinic for the Rehabilitation of Wildlife, Inc. It's a juvenile wood stork that was admitted from Cape Coral. I do have Crow's permission to sketch their photos into my planner. I will link their website and Facebook group down below in case you want to check them out. Here's a chicken with its chick. Here's another bird from Crow. This is a black-necked stilt. So I didn't color that guy in. This is from the Royal Cam Albatross group from New Zealand. And so this is what the baby looked like. Again, I have their permission too to sketch their photos into my journal. I will link their website and YouTube channel down below. I can't remember. Yep, I got back on my bird craze. So here we are again at the end of July. This is an American pika. I don't know if that's how you pronounce it. Okay, yeah, so this is the national bird of Malaysia. So I think I got back on my bird kick here. This is a cookie cutter shark. Yeah, this was interesting because apparently when it bites their prey, it leaves an interesting bite mark on the skin if it doesn't get eaten. It leaves like a mark on the fish's skin, and it was just really interesting. It's a suction cup mark. It's circular. Okay, and then here I was on a kick of old buildings found here in Southern California, like in the early days. So this is called the tamale, the dugout. I should have colored these guys in. This is the oil can restaurant, the big cone, the Sphinx Realty Company. This one I did watercolor. The Hollywood flower pot at 1124 Vine Street in the 1920s. That's so pretty. I kind of wish they left it alone. This is the original Brown Derby on Wilshire. Can you see that? That's the Ben Hur Coffee Shop. This is the Chili Bowl. Hoot Owl Cafe. These are so interesting. People were so creative back then. This is the home of the cone, the ice cream cone. I don't know if you can tell. There are three cones. There's supposed to be a fourth one back here. But because I have, again, if you look at it, the proportion, you know, the direction of it isn't correct. Then we have one with the carrots. So this is for health juices. So they sold juice. This is supposed to be the jumbo lemon, sold lemonade. The Mushroom Cafe. This was located in Burbank. This is the donut hole. This one is in La Puente. I think I read this is still around. It was built in 1968. So apparently, so you see the big donut, and then you drive through like this, and as you're driving through the donut, you'll see them making donuts right here, and then I think at the end of the line is where you place your order. One of these days, I have to go there and check it out. The Pig Cafe. Okay, and then on this day, what did I do? This is Hurricane Hillary coming from Baja, California. I try to draw a picture of myself with my husband. I don't know what we were doing here. But that was a pencil sketch, and I just thought it was so funny looking that I decided to leave it in pencil. I am not good, as you can tell, drawing. Hey, we also had an earthquake. But that's supposed to be me with my Coraline boots. And then there was an earthquake up in Ojai, and it was 5.1. This is Bruce, Kit Kat, and I outside. This is Pup Cafe. This is the Pumpkin Palace. It was a nightclub. This is called the Fish Shanty. I don't know if you can see. That's supposed to be like a big fish. And then you walk through its mouth. This is supposed to be the building. So you walk through the mouth, and then you're inside the restaurant. This is the Hand Car Wash. There was actually a car on top. It was a replica of a 1957 hot pink Corvette up on top. But that's cool. Now this one is a Cadillac Fleetwood. This is the building, and it was a mini mall. So right there, these are the windows, and then this is the door that you would walk in. I kind of wish they kept these buildings. This is the Vandy Camp coffee shop on the corner of Fletcher Drive and San Fernando Road. We used to live really close to this, but we didn't see this. No longer exist. This is called the Shutter Shack. So I don't know if you can tell. So this was built in 1976, and it was this little building. It's supposed to look like an old camera. And it was located in Blakely Historical Park, and it offered one-day film developing. There's an octopus walking on the floor. This is supposed to be an old bookstore in Nagano, Japan. I found the picture on Japan Moments on Facebook. So this is an old school looking building, and then it's squished between two modern buildings. And so I tried to draw that in here. This is the Jack Rabbit Racer, which was the second iteration of three roller coasters in downtown Long Beach. So that's what that's supposed to be, if you can tell. And then if I color it in, this would be the ocean here. And then the sand would be right there. And then this is the pier that has the roller coaster. And then there's the railing looking that way. This is supposed to be the Vancouver Marmot, M-A-R-M-O-T. A whale, another clam. Okay, these I think are extinct animals. As you can tell, I get into these little kicks of things that I want to draw. So this is a Chinese paddlefish. A smooth handfish. It's now extinct. Look how cool it looks. Splendid poison frog. This is the garden orb. Oh, this is the one that was outside her front door. Labrador duck. Western black rhino, declared extinct. This is Peaches. She's the American flamingo released in Tampa. This is my sketch of pioneer chicken. Here's a doo-doo or a dodo. That is a great auk, A-U-K. This is supposed to be a blue butterfly that went extinct recently. But again, you can't tell because I didn't color it. Here's a fox. This is a yellow crazy ant. This is the Chinese river dolphin. The ivory-billed woodpecker. It fell off again. And I think the lighthouses are from the Hobonichi Challenge, so now we'll see lighthouses colored. Okay, take it back, not colored. This one's supposed to be a lighthouse with the big waves smashing against the rocks. This is an awesome photo. That's supposed to be the lighthouse here, and this is the trail to get to it. And I think that's it. A Sumatran rhino calf was born in Indonesia. But there aren't that many left, about 50. That is the end of my flip of the Hobonichi 5-year, my sketchbook doodle book for 2023. My intent for 2024 is to stay caught up. This is supposed to be a fun project for me. It's not going to stress me out. I'm not going to let it stress me out just because I have blank pages. I can just draw right over it and keep moving forward and have fun, because that's what journaling is all about. It's fun. It's supposed to be stress relieving and not stressful. And if you have any questions, feel free to ask them down below. I generally do after the pin videos of my Hobonichi cousin. If I don't see you again, take good care, and I'll see you around. Bye!